Greetings, it's New Zealand naturopath Eric Backer, author of Candida Crusher and formulator of the Candida range of Candida dietary supplements. I'm going to do another case presentation. This will be case presentation number 3. This is out of my book, Candida Crusher. I'm just going to read an excerpt out of that. This patient's name is Trudy and she's 62 years of age. So let's start. If you're a healthcare professional, this will be a typical case that you will see. You'll recognize a lot in this case. So Trudy came to see me not that long ago, complaining of irritable bowel syndrome. She had ongoing constipation and diarrhea for over 10 years. Too many to remember, she told me. Trudy had been treated for irritable bowel syndrome by every practitioner she'd seen and was never considered to be a person to have a serious candida yeast infection. Because she told them all, that is what the medical doctor had diagnosed her as several years ago, IBS. So, of course, once she was labelled as an IBS patient, irritable bowel syndrome is what it was, and that's what all the practitioners basically treated her for. Monkey see, monkey do. You know, I've heard it all before. I call it parrot talk. If you keep parroting the same thing, people start copying, you know that. So, and even many natural practitioners, even some top professionals you saw, treated her for IBS. So they looked at various IBS diets, you know, the SCD diet, the GAPS diet, the Paleo diet, you know, you name it. She's been on every kind of diet, this woman. So I've written here, there were the natural medicine practitioners who'd placed her on strict exclusion diets and the allergy diets, and the doctor had treated her several times with antibiotics before he washed his hands of her and placed her in the too hard basket. The bowel specialist concluded there was nothing the matter with Trudy after all the standard investigations like colonoscopy, endoscopy, abdominal x-rays and countless blood tests all came back as being normal. I've heard it all before. So I've written here also, whenever I teach students about digestive problems, I say if the health professionals diagnose IBS, or if you can't find a reason for the patient's digestive malfunction, suspect an immune problem underpinning it, and usually there's candida not far behind, or dysbiosis, bad bacteria, parasites. You can find blastocystis in there, dying amoeba. You know, there could be any one of a number of different bugs underpinning that, but no one's ever really diagnosed. So Trudy mentioned that she had an itchy scalp, and on close inspection, I noticed that both her big toenails were thickened and discolored. We completed a stool test and there it was, yeast in all three stool samples. But not only yeast, she had also several other bacteria and parasites present, which is typical of a chronic, ongoing yeast case like this. The opportunity exists for such a proliferation of dysbiosis, hence the term opportunistic infection. Right? Trudy had a stool test completed years ago, but was only tested for basic pathogens like Giardia, Campylobacter, Cryptosporidium and rotavirus, so nothing really came up. Many doctors, if they do a stool test, the conventional doctor will do a very narrow test. When I do them, I tend to do a broad test, so I look at a whole range of different things. So this lady used to work at a daycare center, so she was only really checked for like children's infectious bowel diseases, so they basically missed the boat here. All results were negative, and Trudy was left with no answers. So, of course, if all the professionals come back with NAD, non-normal diagnosis, the patient develops increasing anxiety, they start getting mood disorders, they start drinking more, swallowing all kinds of antidepressants, and they just go from bad to worse. So, one of my biggest disgusts with conventional treatment of digestive complaints is the routine and overzealous prescribing of antibiotics. I've seen this with thousands of patients over the years. Antibiotics just destroys people's guts. They just get sicker and sicker to the point where they get there. You know, the doctors wash their hands of these patients. They just get rid of them, discard them for what I call a low-hanging fruit. They look for other patients they can make money out of or give more drugs to, because what can they do? If you make someone sick enough, you can't treat them anymore. Just get rid of them, because there's plenty of other sick people out there. So now you may find them a little bit, you know, strange saying that, but this is based on clinical experience of many years in the business. So Trudy had developed sore throats and chesty coughs in her late 40s and was prescribed penicillin 3 to 4 times a year for a few years, and then developed digestive problems and was then again treated with more antibiotics. As long as the doctors keep on prescribing these drugs, they keep people like me in business. Okay. So what can we learn from Trudy's case? Well, we can learn a lot of things. We can learn that drugs are useless, bloody useless. Giving people recurring antibiotics is like giving people recurring credit. You just stuff people up, you wreck them. So if you're listening to this right now and you're taking recurring antibiotics for a digestive problem, you might as well point a gun towards your head. You're just not going to get anywhere, okay? You need to stop taking drugs. So the better way is to stop these things and improve the gut function rather than, you know, pull it right down. You're just not going to get anywhere. If you want to recover from an illness, why would you take drugs that are anti-life? Antibiosis is anti-life. It just doesn't make sense, right? We got Trudy well, but it took quite a long time. This case took about 9 months to improve. And it was basically just slow diet changes, using powerful antifungals in small amounts. These are the patients that really improve on the antifungal I developed called Candida Remove. So if you go to candida.com, C-A-N-X-I-D-A.com, you'll find this antifungal natural medicine I developed, which is perfect for people with irritable bowel syndrome, inflammatory bowel syndrome, gas, bloating, flatulence, you know, burping, people with any kind of pathogen in the bowel, you know, whether it's rotavirus, cryptosporidium, campylobacter, blastocystis, all of these bugs yield to Candida. I've got thousands of patients now who have emailed me saying that the antifungal works better than any kind of antibiotic I've ever used. So, and all, it's interesting that it's not an anti kind of a treatment either, all right? And you'll find that good antifungals like Candida will not harm beneficial bacteria, especially if you take it just, you know, two or three of these tablets a day. You're not going to kill things. So be mindful of antibiotics. They're going to get you nowhere, all right? Try and lessen your dependence on any medication. Try and improve the diet. Follow some of the principles in my book. You can read a lot more at yeastinfection.org. And don't forget to do my survey. If you go to candidacrusher.com, you can do my online survey to find out how bad you really are in terms of yeast infection. That was case number 3. Thank you for tuning in today.